Hello everyone, my name is Piyush. I have done my graduation from Aligarh Muslim University, and in this video I will talk about my final year project, that was the development of energy efficient battery thermal management system for tropical regions like India. Before moving to the project in detail, I just want to aware you all what are the reasons or factors that push me to choose this topic as my project. As we all know that the population of our country as well as the world is increasing day by day. As a result, the conventional fuels like petrol, diesel, kerosene are depleting very fast rate. Electric vehicles are one of the best alternatives for transportations because they provide eco-friendly as well as the sustainable solution. And that is the reason why the government of India is also pushing EVs market very much. But one of the drawbacks with electric vehicles is that their batteries are very temperature sensitive. They work very efficiently when they are allowed it to work in their optimum working range. So we need to develop a proper battery thermal management system that should cap the batteries within the optimum working range. So in this project
the whole project can be best visualized with the help of this layout diagram, starting with the selection of the cell, followed by the arrangement of those cells either in the series or parallel configuration, or can be the combination of both series and parallel. Then the second most important part was the selection of proper cooling strategy. For example, in Indian regions where the temperature conditions are higher as compared to the cold countries, so liquid cooling is more preferred as compared to the air cooling. Now, different activities like simulations, experimental analysis were performed to develop the smart battery thermal management system and were compared and validated to obtain the desired system. Now, talking about the USP of the project that differentiate this project from all other current available technologies. So the first USP is the concept of battery simulator. This project uses the concept of battery simulator. Battery simulator is basically the analogous to the real batteries. It works for the same purposes as the real batteries do. The advantages of using the battery simulator is that we can analyze any kind of cell for any environmental conditions. So it will help to analyze the properties of different types of cells at different temperature range. So the thermal runaway conditions of different batteries can be also obtained with the help of battery simulator. So this is the CAD model of the battery prototype that I developed in this project with the help of the software. Now the second main characteristic of this project is the self-made data acquisition system. This is the layout of data acquisition system. In this data acquisition system, different kinds of readings like temperature of the battery pack, pressure across any component, coolant flow rate are with the help of their respective sensors to the controller, and that data is used to analyze and interpret many things. These sensors also helps to detect any error within the system and send the signal to the controller that shut down the system spontaneously. So I could say this is the backbone of our system. The third main thing that makes this project more interesting and more valuable is the concept of smart battery thermal management system. So when I talk about the word smart, it means that normally batteries are thermally controlled with the help of constant coolant supply. But in this project, I utilize the concept of variable coolant flow rate according to the temperature of the battery at any particular instant of time. So for example, if I run my battery for 30 minutes, so in case one of constant coolant flow rate, let us say the 7 LPM, so battery will be cooled by the 7 LPM coolant flow rate throughout the 30 minutes. But through this study, the coolant flow rate will automatically adjust according to the temperature of the battery pack. For example, in the initial time phase, the temperature of the battery pack is not high, so it will require lower coolant flow rate, and so on. Its coolant flow rate will changes according to the temperature of the battery pack. So through this concept, around 10% of the energy was saved. And if this concept can be applied to the industrial level, then I hope this concept will definitely help in a bigger scale. So thank you so much for this.